My name is Mikel Villamañe, and with my colleagues, I know Alvarez, Mikel Aranda, and Begoña Ferrero. We are part of the Gala Research Group in the University of Las Palmas. Today I'm presenting a work about rubric-based evaluation and its visualization. And this is a brief outline of the presentation, of the introduction, then the classical visualization of rubrics, our proposal for a new visualization, and some conclusions are feasible. Well, rubrics are mainly intended for formative assessment, where after the evaluation, the students get some feedback that improves, that can improve their learning. But they are also used in summative assessment, where the main goal is to obtain a numerical grade to rank the student's knowledge in a ranking, where you can compare different students, different grades, and you have at the end a fail or pass grade. So this versatility of rubrics has made its popularity grow, and nowadays they are used in all levels of education, and they are considered very useful because in rubrics, the teacher makes the expectations of the work to be evaluated explicit, so the student can self-evaluate himself or herself before delivering the work to be evaluated. And once it is evaluated, the rubric delivers valuable feedback. Valuable is in quotation because even if it is used, it is useful, we think that it can be improved, and this is where this work focuses. In literature, there are mainly two types of rubrics. One is the holistic approach, that is when the work to be evaluated is divided into different parts, and each one of those parts is evaluated, is made an overall assessment of that part. Where we have also the analytic type, where those parts are evaluated with different criteria, and each criteria is evaluated with its proper expectations, and that way the student knows each part of the work, how it is evaluated. So this is an holistic example of a rubric. In this case, it's for an oral defense, an oral presentation. The presentation to evaluate it is divided into different parts that are four dimensions. In this case, content, organization of the presentation, the student's communication skills, and the columns of the rubric are the different levels of performance that can be achieved in each one of the dimensions. In the case of an analytic rubric, those parts, for example, the content, is divided into different criteria. In this case, for example, suitability of the presentation for the topic, user language, scientific accuracy of the content, user resources, and there are also levels of performance where the evaluator selects which is the best, the one that best approaches to the work done by the student in that period. So, as rubrics are very used a lot, we have developed a system to work with evaluation systems and to work with rubrics. We have called ADESMUS, from Adaptable Evaluation Systems using multiple sources. So ADESMUS provides evaluation services, among them some of them to work with rubrics, and allows defining the rubrics and evaluating works or courses using multiple evaluators to evaluate the same task, for example, in a co-evaluation approach in the same classroom, evaluating multiple tasks to obtain a rate, for example, in a course, to evaluate the different parts, the exams, the projects, so on. To use multiple evaluation sources to evaluate one task, for example, we can have, if we have different evaluators to evaluate the same work, one can use the holistic approach of a rubric, and the other one can use an analytic approach. And since rubrics are also used to obtain grades in a summative assessment approach, ADESMUS allows defining different weights for each task, different values for the dimensions of the task, different values for levels of performance, so that way the rubric's grade can be calculated. And of course, ADESMUS provides the results of evaluation and the feedback both to students and teachers. And this is where we are working now in the results and feedback provided. In the case of rubrics, the typical visualization of a fulfilled rubric once the evaluation is made is to somehow mark the level of performance for each one of the dimensions and, when it is needed, to give a numerical grade for that rubric. In this case, this is an analytic rubric, but for the holistic rubric, it's just the same. The marks are in the different levels of performance for each one of the dimensions. So, this approach, this visualization, has its pros and its cons. Among its pros, the students get formative feedback. So, if you see the rubric, you can see what is needed to fulfill in each one of the levels of performance, so the student knows where he or she has failed, and to understand the topic, and so on. And students know where the grades come from, because they know which are the different weights of the different dimensions, and which expectation fulfills and which does not. But this type of visualization has also its cons. For example, the student has no knowledge about his or her performance among the group. It just, the student sees his or her performance, doesn't see anything more. And from this visualization, the teacher has no benefit. The teacher is the evaluator, so he or she already knows which are the expectations the student has fulfilled or not. So doesn't give anything more. So we are working in new types of visualization for rubrics. Mainly, we pretend to enrich visualization of rubrics using different plots. In this case, we propose to use radar plots. In the case of a radar plot, representing a rubric, each one of the axes corresponds to each one of the dimensions, and the scale of the plot of the axis are the different levels of performance. This type of visualization allows, in an easy way, to make comparisons. For example, the student can compare his or her performance with the average of the group he or she belongs to. And here we can easily see that, for example, in the grammar and vocabulary dimension, the student's work is worse than the average of the group, whereas the student has better communication skills than the average of the group. This allows to easily, to the student, to easily spot which are his or her weaknesses and his or her strengths, and take measures to overcome those weaknesses. Of course, this type of plot allows navigation to obtain more information about each one of the dimensions. For example, if the student clicks in the content dimension, the specific information for that dimension is shown. In this case, we can see the holistic version of the rubric, where it's marked the level of performance for the student and for the group. The distribution of the group results, for example, 10% has reached a level of excellence, and 10% is also beginning level. Some feedback can also be shown. This feedback can be automatically generated if, at the time of defining the rubric, the teacher has defined which is the corresponding feedback for each level of performance, or that feedback can be fulfilled when the teacher is evaluating the specific work for the student. As ADESMUS allows evaluating the same work by different evaluators and using different sources, when more than one evaluation is available, there is more information to be shown, the student can also access that information and see the different types of evaluation that his work has been passed. In this case, we were seeing the holistic version of the rubric, but if someone has also fulfilled the analytic version, ambition. This type of visualization we think it's also useful not only to visualize the rubric results, but also to visualize each part of, or each evaluation that has different parts. For example, a course. The course, in this case, the course programming in Java, has four parts that are going to be evaluated, two exams, and one programming project and one oral defense. And in this visualization, we can, the student can, or the teacher can easily see which are the parts that have been already evaluated with our results, and make comparisons with the group, and so on. Of course, this also allows navigation, and when one of the parts is selected, the corresponding information is shown. This visualization is available both for students and for teachers in a very similar way. And for teachers, we also want to enrich the visualization with the possibility to compare different groups and letting that to the teacher to define those groups. For example, it could be different working groups in the same classroom. It could be groups with different teachers to compare the results depending on the teacher and depending on the evaluator. Maybe one of the evaluators is very strict and the other one has evaluated with a loose hand. It would be useful, for example, to evaluate the results when using different teaching or learning approaches, or to compare the results when we have in the same classroom repeaters or and new students. For example, here we have in the course programming in Java two different learning approaches. We have one group working with a project-based learning approach, and we have another group working with inquiry-based learning. And the teacher can see in advance the difference between those groups. For example, in this case, we can see that the inquiry-based learning group obtains better results in the exams, but in the project-based learning obtains better results in the project, but in the oral defense, for example, the results are quite similar. So, some conclusions. Well, we think that visualization enriches the rubric that enriches the feedback that the rubrics give. The rubrics in a classical visualization gives valuable feedback, but we think that this way it can be enriched and it can be used to, in the case of the students, to overcome its weaknesses, his or her weaknesses, knowing which those are, and in the case of the teachers, it can help to improve the pedagogical interventions in the group to improve the group's results. And as a future work, well, this module of ADESMUS is under development right now. It has been tested yet with real data and real users. So the first step is to finish it and make it available for real users, and then analyze students and teachers' visualization preferences, because radar plots are just an option. We think it's useful, but maybe they think they don't agree with us. And once it is available and we have the data, evaluate the impact of the different visualization techniques in the learning and teaching processes.
Are there any questions?
Yeah. Many people in data visualization research still think that a radar plot is not proper for novel users. As you said, what kind of charts and plots have you designed as a plan B?
Yes, the module is under development, and right now it has radar plots, pie charts, bar diagrams, and the typical ones. We don't know which would be the best or the more useful for the student. So that's what we have to, once they have all the possibilities available, to study what they prefer and which is the most useful for each student or for the teachers, but has not to be the same. Maybe the teachers prefer Prada block and the students pie charts, I don't know.
I think that's very interesting because in my business I use rubrics for assessment for students. And I think that I don't know if it's useful, for example, in different moments. For example, I did a in the first moment, second moment, and I would like to compare these moments with the students in the feedback. So is it useful for this type of comparison?
Yeah, you say using the same rubric in different moments along the course, along the time?
Yes.
Then it can be compared. You have different evaluations, so it's just...
It's like this one.
Okay. Yeah, it's like this one. Yeah. It's something like this one. It's to compare the student's performance just at the beginning of the course, in the middle of the course, and yes. At the end of the course. But it's like different groups. It could be used in like different groups. So that way the student and the teacher can see the differences. And,
I would like to analyze if it's useful for students. I would like to have the question with the students to if it's useful for them.
Yeah. We think it could be useful, but as many other things, maybe they have it there and they don't even look at it. So.
Yeah.